Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. This video is on evaluating expressions. When you're talking about an expression has variables, constants, operations, grouping symbols, but no equal sign. An equal sign makes it suddenly an equation, and we're just talking about expressions, so no equal signs. When it says to evaluate the expression, we do that by substituting the given value in for the variable and then simplify by using the order of operations. That's what we mean by evaluate. So let's look at an example. This says evaluate a squared minus b. So we have variables there and an exponent and a subtraction. And it says now it tells us when a is negative 3 and b is 4. So whenever you substitute in for an expression, if you put parentheses around that, it will serve you well. And people don't want to do it, but I'm telling you, instead of a, we want a to be negative 3. So we're going to say negative 3 to the second power. So we just substituted this a for negative 3. Minus, and then b. B is 4. See how I put parentheses around both of those? It doesn't hurt. Sometimes you need it. You definitely needed the first expression. You didn't really need it for the 4, but it won't ever hurt you to do it. Now I'm going to simplify that. So we first substituted. We just did that, and now we're going to simplify. So negative 3 to the second power is negative 3 times negative 3. Negative 3 is the base. So that gives us positive 9. I'm going to go ahead and drop the 4 parentheses there because I don't need it. And 9 minus 4 is 5. This is the evaluated expression. We evaluated that. We plugged in, and then we simplified. We have to use our order of operations, which we did from a different video. Okay, for the example number 2, we have negative x squared. We say evaluate negative x squared when x is negative 1. This negative has nothing to do with that negative. So when I plug into this, I'm going to do it right under here so you can see I still have the negative, and now I'm replacing x. When I replace something, I'm suggesting strongly put parentheses around it every time you do that. Now I'm replacing that with negative 1. X is not just the 1, it's the negative 1. So we had a negative out front, replacing a negative 1 for the x. And now we want to simplify that. We're going to do the exponent first, which has nothing to do with this negative out front. We're going to do negative 1 times negative 1. What you actually have here is negative, and then you have negative 1 twice. That's what this part says, right? Negative 1 to the second power. A negative times a negative is a positive, and then we get positive 1. And we have that negative out front, so it's negative 1, okay? That's a little confusing with the negatives. That's why I wanted to do that. And then I have 3 that I'd like you to try. And the directions are evaluate the expression for the given values. And what you're going to do is take those and plug them in and simplify. As always, I strongly suggest you try it on your own and then come back and see how you did. All right. Every time I replace something, I'm going to put parentheses around it. So you can see what's happening here. Where I used to have x, I'm going to replace it with the value of x that we were given. So we have negative 3. Oops, there's a second power there. And then over here for the other x, I have negative 3 again. Now I'm going to simplify. Negative 3 to the second power is, we saw it up here, 9. And then I have 4 times negative 3, which is negative 12. Now, it's okay right here if you say, well, aren't those two negatives going to make that positive? Yes, it will. We can think about that as plus positive 12. And so we have 9 plus 12, which is 21. All right, number 2. We're going to replace the a with a negative 2. So I'm going to replace that. I'm going to replace b, and I'm going to replace c. I'm putting parentheses there just to enforce to you what I'm thinking of as I do that. The a is negative 2, the b is negative 4, and the c is negative 1. Now I can simplify that because I've got all those values replaced. I've got a negative 2. Negative and negative is going to make that plus 4 over negative 1. In the top I have 2 negatives and 4 positives, more positives by 2, 2 divided by negative 1. Now I have a division problem. I have 1 negative, which is an odd number, so I'm going to get negative 2 for that overall. This is a good chance for you to practice your order of operations, practice your assigned number operations, and also evaluate. So it's all kinds of good stuff in here. For the third one, we're going to replace that Y. Notice what I'm doing here. Wherever I'm going to have to replace something, I'm putting this set of parentheses. Then I go back and put that number in. So for Y, I have 2. I have a 2 here, and I have a 2 there. That's the expression that I'm going to simplify. Notice over here, the negative was not out front. Here it was. That negative has nothing to do with that Y, right? That's just a negative out front. Here, this X has to do with the negative because that's part of what X equals. It equals a negative 3, okay? Our Y just equaled 2. It doesn't have the negative as part of that. So I'm going to do the exponent first, and 2 to the second power is 4. So I have negative 4 there. It is different than this one because this one we're saying whatever X is, take that whole thing to the second power. That means our base is negative 3 here. Here it says whatever Y is, take that to the second power. Our Y was just 2. Our base was positive 2, and so that negative was out front of that. All right, then 3 times 2 is 6. We have a minus 6. And now I'm going to simplify these by combining these up. You might still be changing this. Subtraction becomes addition. The sign of the next term has to change. If you look at all your negatives, you've got 10 negatives and 1 positive, and so you have more negatives by 9. All right, that's evaluating expressions.